I've added a few slides and changed some of the formatting. The slides are ready, but I still want to proof them for mistakes. PowerPoint has some proofing tools, including a spell check, that marks the words that are not included in the dictionary with a red wavy line. See, here is a wavy red line that indicates that a word is misspelled in this sentence. If you just right-click the underlined word, a menu will appear. The menu provides me with a possible spelling of the word, the option to ignore the word that was marked as incorrect, and the option to launch the spelling dialog box. This is the correct spelling, so I'll just select it, and now it is changed in the document. I can do the same thing and right-click blindfold, only now I have three possible spellings of the word to choose from. PowerPoint isn't sure which one is correct, so I have some options. And I think I'll select this one. It looks like we have two more errors to check. Stilltech is the company name. It isn't misspelled, but it isn't part of the PowerPoint dictionary. Now, I can right-click it and see that PowerPoint gives me some spelling suggestions, but this is correct already. I could select Ignore All so it won't be marked as incorrect each time, or I can choose Add to Dictionary. From this point on, anytime I type Stilltech in any PowerPoint presentation, it won't be marked with a red line because it is part of the dictionary. You can continue to proof your slides this way, or you can use a quicker method. Select the Review tab, and in the Proofing group, click the Spelling command. A dialog box appears. The first word that appears marked as not part of the dictionary is roles, and below it a list of possible spelling suggestions. The one that is suggested is not correct, so we need to scroll and select the spelling we want to use. You have some buttons to the right that give you different options. If this word is spelled correctly, you could choose to ignore it, or ignore all. You can also change this one instance of the spelling, or click Change All to change it each time it is spelled this way. You can also add the spelling to the dictionary or ask for suggestions. Let's go ahead and finish spell checking this document. And we can see on this slide that all the spellings have changed. After we change that, the next word will appear, and we'll make a decision about it. You keep doing this until all the slides have been checked. Some other commands in the proofing group include Research, which opens a task pane to the right, so you can search dictionaries, encyclopedias, and other references for information right from PowerPoint. The Thesaurus commands can help you find words that are similar to another word, and the Translate command does just what you think it will and translates text for you from one language to another. Finally, the Language command lets you set the language that you're using for the spell check tool. We can see that we're using U.S. English. In addition to the proofing group, you also have the proofing section of your PowerPoint options. To access these, click the Microsoft Office button and choose PowerPoint Options. The Options dialog box will appear. Select Proofing on the left and then edit your proofing settings. The decisions you make here will determine how PowerPoint operates. Will it mark misspelled words, ignore website addresses, or check spelling as you type? These things are determined by the options you select here. It is important that you know how to access your PowerPoint options and how to use the proofing commands on the Review tab. The spelling command is especially important because the last thing you want in your presentation is spelling errors. Spend some time becoming familiar with these features and be sure to run the spelling tool on your next presentation.